Hi, you guys. Look at my hair. Don't you love it? Don't you love it? Don't you love it? I'm loving it. I should have laid them edges down, but that'll be fine because no, I ain't gonna see them, right? So let's get right into this, you guys. So as you know, I told you I was gonna keep you updated with my virgin hair that I permed. Yes, you heard me right. If your first time seeing this video, I permed my virgin hair. It was in the pattern of deep wave, and it was Brazilian deep wave, you guys. And it was four bundles in the, yes, four bundles in a closure, and this is what you're looking at now. And you guys, the reason why I permed my virgin hair is because it was tangled, it was matting, it was shedding, it was just basically unworkable. It was unusable, and I refused to like throw away all my good hard-earned money for filthy hair that was not worth anything. So basically what I did, I just said forget it. Okay, now first thing first, I did try to work it out. I used silicone mix, I used everything possible to try to get this hair snapping, you know, because I do hair. I've been wearing virgin hair for years, okay, years, and I wear different types of hair all the time. If I'm not buying it, thank God some companies do sponsor me to wear their hair, so I get a chance to try different types of hair, and I never ever fuck up my hair. It don't matter what origin or brand or grade it's from, I never ever mess up my hair because that's I take good care of my hair. So, but this hair was just low grade hair, and I could not deal with it. So I decided to let me just go ahead and just perm it. The video is already up. Be sure to go watch that video. If I get a chance to, please click show more and you can just watch the video there. Please always check the description bar. Now, also, so I permed this hair, and when I permed it got straight. It got pretty straight. It wasn't like bone straight because it still had a nice natural waves in the inside of the root because I didn't get that far up there. I used two boxes of Dark and Lovely. I wouldn't prefer that brand because it felt kind of like it was like hardish, like it had like some dry perm stuff, but it wasn't. I prefer the liquid. They didn't have the liquid. It had like a pouch. You push the stuff out until the activator was creamy instead of liquid. You know how we do perms. You get like the liquid bottle, you pull inside the creamy cup. It was a creamy thing I had to pour inside the creamy cup. I didn't like the cream, I'd rather have the liquid. Now, so I permed it, you guys, with Dark and Lovely, and it still came out good. So the next time the next time you saw the hair, I already permed the hair, and I had, I think I straightened it or something. And I was telling you guys, I feel like I could still smell the perm. The hair felt heavy, like it still had perm in it or whatever. So I said, you know, let me go ahead and give it a bleach bath so it could take everything out. So you guys, if you don't know what a bleach bath is, it's simply put some hot water inside of regular hot water that's inside the faucet, and put some bleach in there, cleaning bleach, you know, Clorox, whatever kind of bleach you have. It could be off-brand from Dollar Tree. It doesn't matter. Bleach is bleach. So I put it inside a nice big pot, you know, like you do on a washboard, washing it out. I see all the perm coming out. I see all the chemicals, everything dealing with the hair coming out, coming out, coming out. So I poured the water out and did it again. I think I did it like two or three times. So as I did that, I rinsed the hair out really good. Then I did get a good shampoo and a conditioner. After I did that, it was fabulous. I came on here with these, that was this one. It was the last video. I came on here with some big bouncy curls. It was gorgeous. You guys remember that? And I got that from the curls was made from the It's Me, no, New Me, Magic Curling Wand. That was a 19 millimeter bar. So yeah, and these curls are actually still from that, you guys, because I mean every time, I mean I haven't curled this hair since then, and these are actually the curls right here. I mean only thing I have curled was this piece right here on my face to make a bang, and this piece right here to make it flip back. But the rest of it is still from that curl when I curled it like a week or two. So this hair is holding up, and the curls are holding up great in this hair. Now, I've been combing them out and combing them out, and guess what? They keep coming back together. They mat not mat together, but you know how curls come together like that. You gotta pull them apart or whatever like that. The hair is very thick. I don't know. I mean, I wouldn't say it's perfect virgin hair, but it's damn sure good hair now. I mean, it holds a nice curl. It looks natural. It's very pretty. It's still soft. My ends may look dry a little bit. Nope, they really don't even look dry. I don't know. But, yeah. You guys, this is not even virgin hair anymore. This is processed Brazilian hair. You guys, this is processed Brazilian hair. And let me tell you, it was well worth it. This hair is well worth it now. So, yes. After perming and a bleach bath and everything, this hair is fabulous. I absolutely love this hair. You know. So, I will be wearing this like this. I've been thinking about bleaching it, but I don't want to bleach it. I want one good solid unit that's super full and, like, bounce back. And I was bouncing back. I mean, it's like everything. It's like everything. So, you guys, like I told you, I'm going to keep you updated on this hair, how it's been holding up. It's going to be like a week and a half now, or maybe 2 weeks. I know a couple of you guys have been asking me about the hair, how is it holding up since you just not permed it. And this is how it's holding up, babies. Honest to God, I love it. Because I wouldn't tell you to perm your virgin hair and waste up your money. But, baby, listen here. I permed mine. And God knows I'm happy I did. So, yeah, and you don't have to be deep wave. You can be body wave if you want some bone straight hair. Because mine was deep wave, so, you know, it's going to take a little bit more umph. But, yeah, definitely, if you don't have some bone straight hair, just to get a nice, good quality relaxer. I like the olive oil kind. I don't know what this brand called, but it's the olive oil relaxer out there. And I think maybe in a couple of weeks, I may perm this hair again, you know, to make sure it's bone straight or whatever. And it's still going to have that thick volume because it was deep wave hair. So, yes, you guys. I'm loving this hair. It's 100% hands down beautiful. I just can't brag on it enough right now. I know one thing. I would never order from this hair company again because I had to perm my deep wave hair. And that's all I ever wanted was some deep wave hair. And when I finally got it, it wasn't nothing I wanted because it was tangling, it was shedding, it was matting, it was just hair coming out. I was hurt about it. And I bashed their ass for a long time. I don't usually bash companies, but I wanted to be known, like, you're untrustworthy. You sent me some fucking raggedy ass hair, you know, and then you sent me a closure that didn't even match deep wave. You sent me a loose wave closure with a deep wave pattern. So I had to go on eBay and buy me a freaking closure. And this is where this closure came from, eBay, you guys. So the closure is holding up okay. It curls. I mean, I bleach bathed that just like I did everything else. Even though there was the hair, it had the same treatment as the other hair. So, you guys, yes. All around, I give this hair 8 or 9 since I permed it. I'm happy with the results. So, yeah. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to rate, subscribe, comment. Always follow me on Instagram at MrsRepOn2010 and also MrsRepOn2010_, you guys. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye, babies.